Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and good morning. I just thought that it would be a great time for me to do an update of my skincare and also do a get ready with me and an unready with me. Just thought that, you know, it would be great if I share my routine that I do and how I prep my skin before I go out. Yeah, so I wanted to share the products that I use and recommend some of them. First of all, I'm gonna wash my face.
Typically, there are two face wash that I use. The first one is this ETUDEHOUSE Peach 6.5 Whip Cleanser. I really like this. There's no reason to hate this, and I've been using it for a very long time. I think this is like my third or fourth bottle, so you can tell how much I love this. This, I like whip cleansers because they're very fuss-free. And the second one is a face wash that I got recently. It is this rice powder wash by comeitto. I recently just found out about them, and they actually sell rice products very similar to some that I use. They have like rice toner, rice essence, and rice powder wash and so on. I like it because it's very, you don't have to use a lot at one time, so cost efficient, I would say. Alright, so I'll show you how this works. So you don't have to use much. In fact, I actually overpoured, but and then what you have to do is just mix it with water and start rubbing and lathering. And you see how fast that is? That was how fast the bubbles started to form. It's a no fragrance kind of product. I would say this is definitely not the most moisturizing facial wash that I know, but it does it okay for me. Yeah. Alright, face is clean. Now let's move on to the next step, which is moisturizer. Okay, so the first is the SoonJung Cica Relief Toner Pad. Use this toner and just put it all over my face. It's very partial though, but this has a slight sticky residue to it after you let it rest on and set on your face for a little while. But it's not too bad. Okay, now that it's all dried up, I like to put one more step, which is the SoonJung Emulsion. I put emulsion and not like this barrier cream is because the barrier cream... I just feel like my makeup wouldn't stay. It wouldn't sit well with on my face. If I have the time, normally before I even put on my toner pads, I would use a face mask. Okay, so the next step would be makeup. Got this new foundation and I haven't tried it before, but I'm quite sad because I feel like the shade that I chose is a bit too light for me, but we'll see how it goes. It's the No-Sebum Powder Cushion. This is basically a cushion foundation but with like a powdered texture. Powder foundation does not work well with dry skin, at least for me. So I feel like I might have to moisturize my face quite a bit if I'm gonna use this. Oh, and also I want to try out this new contact lens that I got. It's from OLENS, and the one that I got is a French gold Hazel. So I'm gonna use my concealer and just conceal any imperfection spots. I also recently got this concealer. It's the Cover Perfection Pot Concealer by Saem. I usually use this for like my eye bags. Anyway, I would just leave the concealer on for a while just to settle it in. But I'm gonna blend the concealer that I put earlier on. I've always wanted to try the Really With Me video, you know, have like a long video about just talking. So yeah, I've actually thought about what to talk, and since I'm also doing a skin and skincare update, I just thought that maybe it would be best for me to talk about skin. For that, I'm just gonna blend it out now. I just want to talk about my skin troubles and how I do them. I'm gonna use my foundation now. I do have some troubled skin sometimes. I'm blessed, but my parents do not have acne, because I think sometimes these are caused by genes as well. So I never really dealt with acne before. I've only dealt with like really long stain pimples, but not like acne. And I have really dry skin. Sometimes when I'm feeling too stressed out, then my pimples would start appearing. I did not have much skin problem
when I was in secondary school, so maybe around 12 years old to 16, yeah. Only after I graduated secondary and entered poly, I think there were a few times I definitely had some bad breakouts. But if I feel like my breakouts are at obvious spots where I can't conceal them or at least like hide them for most of the time, you know, because we're wearing masks, right? If it was here, like on my forehead, I can't conceal them because, you know, sometimes when you conceal pimples, it just looks even more obvious. I know it's quite bad, but I personally don't like to wait it out for my pimple to, you know, just naturally come up by itself. So I like to pop them, and because I pop them, sometimes it causes scarring. I'm not sure if you can see it, but I have one tiny scarring here right now because I popped it quite some time ago and it's still healing. I'll be doing my brows, and I'm so sad because I dropped my brow powder, and this is what it has become. My skin kind of affected the way I carried myself outside. Shoot, I don't have my eyebrow brush. Okay, I'll just use this angled brush then. So not having good skin made me feel not confident of myself, which is very normal. When I went out, people would just be staring at me and be like, oh look, her skin is really bad, look at all those pimples on her face. I would say that my pimples were not very bad, but it's just, if you're insecure about that thing, you know how it eats you up, right? Especially when I have those really obvious breakouts on my forehead. I really did not want to go to school, or I did not want to, I know it's kind of stupid saying it, but I did not want to like basically see people, or actually let people see me. You know, and just at some point of time, I guess, I realized that breakouts are completely normal. Everyone has them. Everyone, literally. And I realized that this kind of thing, like a skin problem or that, it's not something I should just sit in one corner and cry about. It's, if I can do something about it, which is why I decided to finally pay attention to skincare and started finding skincare products that works for me. So it took me some time to find the right ones. I don't think I'll change my skincare routine anytime soon, but with that being said, I am always open to trying out new products. I found this really good lip balm. It's by Holika Good Cera. Well, I tell you, this lip balm has done wonders for my lips. I always use it at night. It's a bit of like the oily type. So this is currently my number one favorite lip balm right now. Okay, so I'll be moving on to my eyes. I decided I wanted like a darker look, and this is the Multi Cube palette by iMeme. I don't know how you pronounce this. Some people, I see the word me, M-E-M-E, I pronounce it as meme, but I don't know if it's actually iMeme. I like how in this palette they label it 1, 2, 3, 4, so I'm just gonna follow this. Anyway, I would like to say that this palette pigmentation is quite strong, so usually for the first color, I don't put a lot. Just a bit. I feel like if I use too much pink, it makes me look like I have swollen lids. So, I'm gonna avoid that. I'm using this brush. Being introduced to makeup did motivate me to take care of my skin even more, because I realized that if I didn't have a good base, if I have dry skin, I can't really do much. In fact, if I have dry skin, I prefer not to use makeup at all, because sometimes it makes me feel a bit insecure. For me, skin is a big thing, so when I don't have good skin, it makes me feel a bit insecure of myself. Like, oh no, if this person is standing really close to me, can he or she see my really cracked, dry skin? So that's even more of a reason why I decided to take care of my skin and make sure that that does not happen. I mean, it definitely takes time and discipline, but after, you know, I'm using shade number 2 now. Because I'm also quite an impatient person, this kind of thing is long term. It does not work so fast. You really gotta commit to it. And that's what I did. Your skin is basically like a long term relationship. You need to take care of it. You need to avoid some drying products. Sometimes, for facial wash, when you can feel your skin squeaky clean, that's not actually a good thing, I feel, because that just means that it strips away all your natural oil, and because your skin is stripped of the natural oil, it works even harder to produce oils, and it causes your face to be really oily, and these oils also causes your skin to break out. Okay, so I'm using the color 3 now. Recently I've been into using my fingers for the darkest color to put it near my ends. I don't know. I don't know, I feel like my finger applies it better than my brush. This is PERIPERA's brow liner. I love it so much. Okay, this is where I can't really talk because it's a lot of focus. Okay, I'm gonna blend it out real quick. Sometimes the struggle is making them fit. I think one of them is like these. Letter one of them is slightly winged up, but if it's not too much of a difference, you know, I just go with it. Can't see the boo boo, I just go with it. I'm gonna curl my lashes now with this lash curler. After finding what works best for me, I think obviously I'm a lot happier. I definitely am able to go out in confidence, and even if I do have breakouts, I don't feel ashamed of it. Breakouts are normal. I'm gonna use this Dr. Mascara Fixer in Natural. It is so good. This literally helps my curls to stay super long. Get this. I got Natural, so the lash fibers are in white, so I'm gonna coat them again with my black mascara. Recently, I got this ETUDEHOUSE Curl Fix Mascara. I've heard a lot of good reviews about this, so decided to get it. This is how the brush looks like. I'm not gonna put too much, I'm just gonna put it on a white part. Gonna use my contour palette from ETUDEHOUSE. Gonna use this shade first to just make my forehead look smaller. And then gonna use this shade to make my jawline pop. I used to be really insecure about how I looked, and I just felt like it was taking over me. That affected my behavior such that I didn't really want to socialize. It affected my social life using this brush. And the first shade, that is also another reason why I chose to pick up makeup. It made me feel happy, looking glamorous. But actually at some point of time, makeup became one of my insecurities. Because I had a ex-friend, very toxic. He would tell me mean stuff because he knew about my insecurities, and he would just make fun of it. He would say stuff like, if we're ever going out, don't stand beside me. I don't want to be seen standing next to a clown. Or if we're walking along a roadside, I would make sure that you're the one standing outside. So if anything happens first, the clown dies, not me. And I don't think I'm being petty because I have asked a few of my closest friends. Even if it's just a joke between friends, I don't think you should say that kind of stuff. Especially if you knew that my insecurity was makeup. Because at the time I was getting started with makeup, so I was like, oh no, I'm not really sure if this is good and stuff. He would tell me stuff like, you're nothing but a catfish. You look so good with makeup. I know, just a second ago he was saying I look like a clown. You look so good with makeup, but the moment you take that off, that's who you are. So no one would want to date that, no one would like that. You know, you're just nothing but a catfish. And that really made me feel like quite hurt by it, because for a period of time I was just like, yeah, I am nothing but a catfish. My response to that now is yeah. So what if I'm a catfish? So what if I look good? Sometimes your insecurities can be formed because of the people around you. And when they do, you know that's walking red flags and you need to cut them out of your life. I don't need people like him to trample on my insecurity to boost his ego and pride up. Ooh, I got this new blush, Better Aroma, and it's a collab between Neonmoon. It's the Better Than Cheek blush. Color is so beautiful and the packaging is so cute. I'm gonna use this really fat blush brush. Oh, and apparently this has like a blurring effect. Nothing to hate about it. Using this highlighter, I really love the shine that this Romaine highlighter gives. The glow is very natural. So yeah. Oh, look at that glow. Ooh. Yes, I may be a catfish. So what? When I take out my makeup and all that, that is also still me. What are you gonna do about it? I'm gonna use this two ETUDEHOUSE's fixing tint, ginger milk tea and salmon brick. This is one of the newer colors that just came out. Yeah, I'm gonna go change my clothes and I'm gonna head out. Once I'm back, I will take off all my makeup and then I'll show you like how I prep my skin before I sleep. So see you guys in a few hours. Bye. Hi. I'm so dead tired. I just want to quickly shower and like get rid of this full face makeup. I gotta sleep. I'm so tired, but okay.
Okay, so I have two cleansers that I would love to recommend to people who have dry skin. First one is Bonjour Mellow Mild Milk Cleanser. It is a bit of like oil texture type, so that's why I feel that oil texture type of makeup removal cleansers are great for people with dry skin, because your skin will still be moisturized without being stripped of its natural oil, you know? And the second one is Muji's Oil Cleanser. This one is either a love or hate. I know some people who hate the smell. I'm okay with the smell personally. And I usually use this makeup remover to remove my eye makeup and lip makeup. This by Clarins. I love it. I swear by it. It's so good. I'm gonna use this one. And I like the smell. Very milky. And then I remove the remaining makeup with my Clarins. And for that, I use a cotton pad. Now, I don't need to use much actually, because this is some helpful stuff. Now I'm gonna shower and then I'll be back with my skincare. So see you in a bit.
Hello, so I'm back from showering and just realized I forgot to remove my contacts, but I'm too lazy for that. I'll just remove it once I'm done with everything. Okay, so I actually use daily scrubs. Scrubs are quite rough on your skin. How could I use them daily? Well, the ones that I have here, they're actually very gentle on the skin. I just finished using my previous ones and I ordered them, so they're brand new. But I've been using them for actually quite a while. This is not new on my channel. If you haven't seen it already, I have used this in my Corel unboxing video, so you should check it out. This mask is also from Corel, and I'll explain more about it in a bit. This rice mask, it contains 9 kinds of native rice bran extract that are actually harvested in Korea itself. So because I have two masks, what I usually do is I apply this rice wash or facial mask on both my cheeks. This is also suitable for sensitive skin. I have very sensitive skin and my skin showed no reaction, so that's good. And I really love the very creamy texture. Now it is up to you on how you want to apply this mask. There's no like specific way on how you want to apply this mask. Some days I actually just use the rice mask as a whole. Some days I use this as a whole. Some days I mix it up like today. Let me introduce to you what this is. This is the Mung Bean Wash Off Facial Mask. It's essentially the same as this, just that this contains mung bean instead. It is a clay mask that helps to cleanse and remove impurities on the skin. This is how it looks like. Ooh, nearly dropped it. Saved, got him. Okay, I'm biased to the rice. I still prefer the rice mask smell. But this is also not too bad. If you've had red beans before, it actually kind of just smells like red beans, but slightly sweeter. There is no definite way on how you want to split the mask up. I just do it based on how I'm feeling that day. It's really up to you. I got this from the website Corel. One thing I like about them is that they are very affordable. They provide good skincare products that is pretty affordable. If you're looking for good scrubs that you can use daily, I highly recommend looking at Corel's House of Dilhua. So I'll leave this on for 10 or 15 minutes and then I'll wash my face with warm water. These masks are easier to remove with warm water. I forgot to mention that it would be best if you keep these masks in your refrigerator, because when you take them out to put them on your face, the cooling sensation is really, really very good. I kid you not. You trust me on this. You definitely want to try popping it in the fridge.
So, see you guys in 15 minutes. I did do the mask for, you know, consistently for I think around 3 months now. This would be my third or fourth month. And yeah, and I would say the results are paying off. Now I'm gonna use my rice bran toner. Can you see how much I use? Please don't mind the bubbles. I'm on such a klutz. I knocked it down and it rolled away from me because when I was trying to get it, I kicked it away. So that's why it has a lot of bubbles. So it's normally not like that. Okay. So I'm gonna use any regular cotton pad and just put it on. Or if you don't want to use cotton pad, it's fine. I love to spam this rice toner. It feels so good. Sometimes when I feel a bit extra, I would take 3 cotton pads and soak them with the rice bran toner and just paste them on my forehead, my cheeks. Just like a DIY mask that you can make with your own toner. While waiting for my toner to dry, I'll take this time to introduce to you Balm. So this is the rice bran extract mask, sheet mask. This mask contains ingredients such as rice bran and rice bran extracts that helps to brighten and moisturize the skin while also providing it with the nutrients that the skin loves. I've actually used this a few times. This would be my third time. I do love the mask, nothing to hate about it. Also, I would like to mention that in my previous Corel video, I got a Cica mask and I actually loved it a lot that I bought it, the whole box. However, I don't think it's available in Corel anymore, at least for now, because I tried buying it back but I couldn't find it anymore on the listing. Maybe out of stock, I'm not so sure, but I do like the mask. It's very creamy. I love the creamy texture. Let's open this. It actually smells exactly like the rice scrub. The sheet mask is 100% made from cotton, so it's suitable for all skin types, including sensitive skin like mine.
What I'm doing here is squeezing the life out of this sheet mask packet to get the remaining essence in it out, and then I will put it on my mask on my face. This is so that I can get my money's worth, right? For anyone wondering why I put the mask on my lips as well, I do this for all my masks. It's just to moisturize my lips because usually the chin part is a little bit big for me. So I just use this as a chance to moisturize my lips. Now I'll leave this mask on for 15 minutes and then I'm good to go.
Let's do a test, shall we? I'm gonna let you see how much essence is in this mask. That's a lot. That was just to let you guys see how much essence was in the mask, because sometimes, you know, you might feel a bit cheated. So in my previous Corel haul, I bought one which is Scintilla Asiatica, and as you can see, I've used a fair bit. I bought 2 more as well, and one of them is Q10. I chose this Q10 because this contains melanin and collagen, which helps the skin have a nice glow. And the other is probiotics. I chose probiotics because I like the fact that this in the description it said that it would be able to lock in moisture for dry red skin. I don't have red skin, but I do have very dry skin, and it does lock in the moisture. These two are like super tacky and sticky, so you don't exactly feel it when you're applying on your skin, but once they settle down, it's really quite sticky, like you can do the bouncy thing on your skin. If you're someone like me who prefers lightweight texture, maybe this is not it for you, but I do use these two once in a while when my skin is really tired and really dry. This I would use my night cream, which is the Rise brand facial moisturizer. I actually always use these two together, but on some days where my skin is just not having it, I would mix these two together with my night cream. Very heavy and oily face, but the next morning, usually my face is okay. Just to show you the texture, this is the Q10, and it looks pretty watery. And it feels kind of watery. But once you actually start blending it out, you can feel that it's actually very thick in content. And when you, once you let it settle, it's really quite sticky. Now, for the probiotics, however, you would think that the probiotics is a thicker concentration. I feel like when you put it on your skin, it feels thicker. But when you actually spread it out, it's not as thick as I thought it would be. In fact, I feel like the Q10 is thicker once you actually spread it out. However, today my skin is not in need of that heavy moisture. My skin has been doing well so far, so I'll just be using my Sintelis Cica and together with my cream. When you have the potions, you can be very versatile and flexible in how you want to use them. You can use it alone, or you can mix it together with the other potions, or you can mix it together with your cream. So I love that it's very versatile. Alright, I'm gonna go blow dry my hair and then I'll do an outro for this video. I think I just want to end off this video saying that it's really important to find a good and suitable skincare routine that suits you. I used to not give two hoots about skincare, but I realized that it was really not healthy for my skin to be flaking almost every day. Especially for the people out there who do makeup, it is also very important to have good skin, because good skin means good base, means better makeup application. Last but not least, I wish everyone good luck in finding what works best for you. It took me some time, but I found mine, so I'm very sure that you guys will be able to do so. Thank you very much for watching this video. I really loved doing this Get Ready With Me and Unready With Me content, and I can definitely see myself doing more of this. So you can expect more of these kind of videos coming out. So see you guys in my next video. Bye!